So another useful sort of subcategory of record data is document data. So in this case, it kind of is somewhat similar to a data matrix. Every term, every entry, every data attribute has a numeric value. But in this case, we've got counts. We've got discrete values. So in this case, what we have here is each row, each data object is represented by what we think of as what we call a term vector. So this term vector in this case, and there's several ways you can do it, but in this case, it just counts the number of times a given word appears in the document. So document one has team appear 3 times, play appear 5, but coach appear none. Document two, on the other hand, has coach appear 7 times, but never has play appear in the over the course of the document. So because these attributes are all discrete, because they're all integer attributes, we can do different kinds of things. Different kinds of algorithms and processing methods are appropriate than data matrices or mixed data is. All right, so the last special kind of record data that we're going to talk about here is transaction data. So this shares some similarities to document data, and you can use some of the same analysis, but there's different semantics around it as well. So transaction data is exactly what it sounds like. It's record data where each record involves a set of items. So if we're at a grocery store, the set of products purchased by a customer during one shopping trip constitutes a transaction, and the individual products were purchased are the items. So we can The difference between this and document data is that usually these items have more information than just a count associated with them. So not only is it bread, there's a price associated with that. There's maybe an inventory stock associated with that, how many are left, all of those sorts of things. So we can do sort of things similar to document analysis, but there's other sorts of information we have to consider as well. So that's transaction data.